8 hours a day. Seems quite doable, actually. I don't know if I would do it, but well, maybe if I could and had enough to talk about or to show. Yeah. Why not? Especially, of course, the pro gamers who play games like StarCraft 2 and stuff like that. They make pretty good money out of it. Well, of course, if you have enough viewers and subscribers, and if you stream enough. Hello, Mr. Milk Truck. But then again, if you could make money, or if you would, if you could make a living out of doing something you're good at, and it really, I don't really care if it's gaming or making music or I don't know, picking your nose, then yeah, why not, you know? I think people should be more encouraged these days to do what they're good at instead of what makes the most money. Oh my, no, 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 oh my god, why did I press that button? Go, 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 go. Full throttle. So yeah, what I was saying is, if you're good at something, and you know, there are a lot of people who play like StarCraft 2 or League of Legends that are really good, and you know, they are pro players. So yeah, why shouldn't you make more money with that? Well, it's the same for people who, I don't know, make jewelry or clothes or something. Yeah, well, I mean, you're probably good at it and you... Oh crap, anyway. And you have your own brand, and you, well, basically what they do is they know how to sell it. And if you're a good gamer and you know how to sell yourself by, you know, doing live streams or tournaments or get sponsored. I've got nothing against that. I mean, if I could make my money making music, I wouldn't hesitate doing that. It's too bad that the whole music, making money with music is so hard these days, well, especially here in the Netherlands when it comes to earning money with gigs. You know, people tend to see it as a hobby and think, oh yeah, it's your hobby, you play in a band, hell, really nice, and you should be glad that we want you to play at our stage, instead of, you know, yeah, okay, it's a hobby, but if you're pretty good at it and you have a nice following, is it really Should you really go everywhere and just, you know, play for free or play for a couple of beers, while you maybe invest thousands of dollars in, you know, equipment, guitars, drum sets, you know, paying the practice area or stuff like that. And I really think that is really going a wrong way. Currently. And of course, maybe that's also what I just said. Well, you can be good at something and that's good, but you also have to find a way to sell yourself. And that's really a department where I really suck at. I mean, I'm capable of doing things at a certain level, but I really haven't got a clue how to market myself or to sell myself. And that's just because that's not learned to me. I don't why not? It's basically not in my what's it called? I'm just not good at it. I haven't learned from it, haven't learned it. I do understand it to some point, but I'm just too shy to really be sort of arrogant. You know, when I know I'm good at something, and there are some things I'm pretty good at, I just don't know how to sell myself without sounding like a whore. Spinning Fager, I'm not going to do this mission actually. This mission is nearly impossible, so yeah, if there would be a possibility that I would make money out of something I like doing and doing it full time, well, it would be nice. But then only things I really like, enjoy doing, and not for a boss or something else, just really being my own boss. And I sort of try to do that right now, but by my websites and some YouTube videos, but man, it's really hard. And because I have a normal full-time job, I don't have the time to focus myself on doing those other things. And you might think, well, why are you live streaming right now? Well, because it's Sunday. Everybody needs some time off once in a while. But to be honest, I will never be a professional gamer or whatever, but if I could make a living of all the things combined of what I really like doing, and that would be a mixture of making music, or mixing music, playing games, and videotaping myself about playing games, and making websites and maintaining websites, I would have a pretty fucking damn good life. Well, if I could make my roaming costs per month by running my websites, or the revenue from there, from that, it would be, I mean, that would give you so much freedom, you know, and then you can focus on the things you like and really get better at them, and you know, get advantage of the fact that you're getting better at something you really like. But hey, for now it's all dreams. Maybe someday it will be reality, but I should invest so much time into every aspect of getting there. You know, I mean, I think I could make a living of the ad revenue I have with my current website. Maybe, no. I mean, I know I could make more, but I would have to have a couple of months and spend those months full time on maintaining those websites and keep them up to date, and then I think I could get somewhere. But still, there is that thing of marketing where I really suck at. That's still my issue, you know. Things don't just happen. Well, they might just happen, but they need some sort of kickstart, or you know, stuff has to go viral, or you have to get linked at a certain well-known website. That could really get it a boost, but that's not really, my focus isn't really on the viral stuff. Man, I have a dry throat about this talking. So we have some more canola. Excellent. Alright, so we've done this. Get you out of the way again. And we'll just sew it again. Of course, after we've cultivated it. And let's get it out of the way just a bit further. Also, the whole thing I talked about you know, getting yourself marketed, that's really also my issue with my YouTube channel. you know, I upload videos every day or almost every day, and I've been doing that for a couple of months now, and still I haven't got much subscribers. And there are two reasons why. One reason is that I don't play games that other people play a lot, because I like to be different. You know, I could play Call of Duty or, you know, or Battlefield or something like that, but I don't really like those games, or I haven't played them and I'm not planning on playing them. So I only play games I like, and there are a lot of people that might like those games, but they, I don't know if they know that I do let's plays about them. Alright, I play Minecraft, but that whole hype is a bit gone, I guess. So maybe if I would have done this a year sooner, then I had probably hit the jackpot. Well, sort of. But no, it's too how do you say that? That market is too saturated. So yeah. I mean, I'm still uploading my Minecraft videos, and I'm still having fun playing it, so I'll just keep doing it. But in the meantime, I'm thinking of playing other games so I can get some following. And that's probably what my next week will look like, is finding a game that I will let's play. And I think I have already found it, but I should buy it. But yeah, that it might take some time before I will upload that. But I will probably upload my Minecraft videos only once a week. So that I can create a nice buffer of videos to upload. For the rest, SimCopter I will certainly continue playing, because I think that the game is it's just fun to play. Alright, we'll keep the time going till it's like, where is that? Oh, we'll do that. Yeah, that's a nice one. Because I'm not making nearly enough money, and it's pretty close to here. But yeah, I'm really now focusing on finding games that I like to play and want to play for a longer period of time. I mean, Minecraft is a great game, but I cannot play it for, you know, 4 hours in a row. It just but then again, I am pretty much a casual gamer, so I don't like to completely dive myself in a game and lock myself in my room and play it for a month, you know. I like to change it sometimes. It's also kind of what happened with my Dungeon Keeper Let's Play. I recorded one episode and it's kind of it's the recording stopped when I was 20 minutes in, and I didn't know that, so that episode was ruined. So I'm now still contemplating whether I should redo that mission or just continue with the game. And I think I'll just continue on with the game, but I'm it sort of put me off the game for some reason. And also I'm not particularly good at Dungeon Keeper, but that's not really that bad. But come to a point where I really question myself if I should go on with it. So there's a great chance that I will just pick it up, well, in some time, but currently I don't feel like playing that game. That's also because, no, I like Dungeon Keeper, but I'm not really good at it, and I play it in a too casual way, I think. And that's why I should just focus on games that I like and are pretty casual, and will probably end that most of them are simulation games. But to be honest, that is what I like to play, so. Why don't you move the tiny bit further? Alright. 80 grand to go. Checkpoint. Seed it and fertilize it at the same time. Oh yeah, should speed up the time again. Hopefully we'll get a great amount today. I think the most problem I have with playing games is that I get hooked. I play it a lot in like a couple of weeks, and then something happens. And it doesn't even really have to be that I don't have that the game sucks or bugs out of me, but that I. But like with Christmas and stuff like that, that I don't have time to play games, or if something else happens, and then you get out of that flow and you don't play the game anymore. And that's what I have with a lot of games. I play them a lot for a couple of days or a couple of weeks, and then suddenly other things happen and I don't play those games anymore. And when I do have the time to play them again, I feel like I have to, well, not really relearn it, but yeah, sometimes it feels like relearning it, you know, you're out of the flow, you have to get back at the stuff, how things happen. Yeah, that's a bit of a thing that I encounter with a lot of games. I mean, I've been playing League of Legends a lot, half a year ago. And then I got busy doing other stuff and League of Legends, I didn't play it anymore. So an opportunity arrived that I could play it again with some friends, and I did that, and I just sucked at it because I didn't know exactly what the how to play it more, or what the best skills were and stuff like that. So that really, yeah, and then you, I think I hadn't played it for 2 months or something, so I played it again once and I just completely sucked, and I felt like I had to relearn the complete game. And especially with League of Legends, where new champions come out every 2 weeks or something, you really have to play it a lot to keep up with the with the game actually. I don't have the time for that. That's the only explanation. I mean I work full time. I have a lot of other stuff going on in the evenings, so I can play in weekends most of the time, but sometimes you just don't want to because you know it's the point where you haven't got your mandatory things like your job. So that leaves like 2 or 3 days or evenings where you can actually play games or upload it or record it or whatever. And when you play a game like League of Legends, yeah, you have to play every day or every other day. Well, from my experience. And the people I know who do that really, yeah, they're pretty good at it, and you know they play a lot, and but they also when they have some spare time they don't do anything else than playing League of Legends. Well, that's just not really my cup of tea. Okay, off to the biogas plant. I mean, sometimes I would just want to go home and lie on the couch and watch TV. And I spend a lot of time watching other OPers play their games. Well, that's enough rambling for me for right now. Let's focus on the game again. So we're going to, to sow some wheat. And then I'll probably take a break for some dinner. Because hey, that's what I need. Select wheat. I'll be handy. Let's fertilize this joint. Again. Should I just put this at the front? Yeah, why not? No, no, no. Press the wrong button there. Nope, I'm fertilizing right now. Wish the game would give me another mowing mission real soon. It would be nice. And I know I'm not really fertilizing efficiently yet. I don't want to miss parts. It's pretty quick at the lighting actually. Fertilizer should go here because I'd like to put them in order, you know, from cultivating to sowing to fertilizing. And I know the plow is in the wrong way or in the wrong position. I don't use plow. I will use it when we have our new harvester and I'll buy field 15 and connect 15 with 16. So we have a bigger field. Ah, look at that. Here we go. Something in the background is my cat playing with her toy. It's like a ball in the sort of in a real. Put the beacon on. Yeah, I really want to get the harvester today. We have made a decent amount of money already. It will be so much easier with a new harvester. Probably if we get a great demand for something, we might be able to buy the more expensive harvester. And if that's possible, I'm really going to do that. Because the attachment on the front is, if it's 2 meters wider, that's gonna save a lot of time. It's probably quicker and, you know, all the jazz. Alright, almost done here. Empty it. And get $250 for it. Are you only here? Oh yeah, and that thing isn't that wide. Excellent, okay. Halfway yet. Yeah, like exactly halfway. Excellent. Finally some quick missions. Get this out of the way. Like the lawn mowing missions because they're easy and you get a lot of money for it. Especially when you have all the attachments and a decent tractor to do these missions. Hilarious that the mowing extension is bigger than the tractor itself. It's probably why it maneuvers so badly. It's even worse when I fold it in and just get an eternal wheelie. Come on, give me the money. Look, when I fall it in, maybe I should turn it off. I think it can. Does it spin? Oh, it doesn't spin. That's too bad. Wheelie! So yeah, that's not really, that's not good. So, what was I doing? Alright. Getting the furthest ready to pick up the harvest. Are you still not done? So yeah, main priorities, a better harvester and a bigger tipper. Tippers aren't that still still. One second. She moves better. No, I don't have to have those. No. Just by, yeah, tippers. This one we have now. We probably will want this one. Is 2100 thousand. Okay, why not? Pretty close anyway. We have to go to... Island. Okay. think when I play the next time I will make an overlay for my stream, so people can check out my YouTube channel and my website about this game. Yeah, that would be a nice thing to do. So if there is still anyone watching, which is no one, god damn it. Yes, I do have a YouTube channel, which is A Noob Plays Games. Just written without spaces or underscores or dashes or whatever. So you can check my Let's Plays there, or my tips on Farming Simulator 2013, which we are currently playing. These tutorials are basically the front loader missions, which I've been doing all day. But yeah, for a first live stream, I think it's been a great success, actually. Of course, it would be nice if 10 people would watch it. Rome wasn't built in one day. Gonna reach it before the 1 minute mark. Come on. Yes. Brilliant. So we're all done. Good job. Maybe we can speed up the time again. I thought you should unfold it. Let's see if there's a horseshoe somewhere here. Some mushrooms. Seemed like a nice location for it. Oh my god, he's stolen a golf cart. Oh my god, that's fucking awesome. Underwear hanging to dry. Let's slow them down again. See if we can set a new record when it comes to cutting the glass. Last time you had 500 and something bones. Sell the other one, of course. Still, I'm gonna be so happy when we got the new one. It's gonna save us so much time. I would only have to get a bigger tipper so we don't have to drive so much when selling it again. Maybe I should make a Farming Simulator 2013 drinking game. That would be fun. Every time you have 1 minute to spare on the mission, you have to drink. Something like that. Every time your hired worker crashes. Nice! Because also crashes into a tree, you have to drink. Oh, that's so slow. $180,000. Well, I wish I was that rich. Where's the? Yeah, I'm leaving. Speed up time again. Because the more time we skip, the faster we'll get it taken out. What do you say? The ports. Alright. Man, this game. My wishes have been granted. So we have to pick up Kimola. You can see the items on the silos. So Kimola is this one. And we probably have to drive a lot of times, but buckle off. So yeah, off to the port. Now we're really getting somewhere. Oh yeah. So it's taken us 5 hours before we got our first crate demand and therefore our first loader. And we'll probably have to drive 3 times. Yeah, a bigger tipper would definitely be a nice addition, because then we could have had it all gone in one trip. But yeah, well, I have to fill my time anyway. So I wonder how much money do we get for that? Wow, 1800 per ton. And we've got like 5 tons here. $10,000. I guess? Not really that much. No. But it does mean that we're really getting somewhere. So here we are at the port. And we deliver it right here. So we have 180 right now. Yeah, okay, just as I thought. So we'll end up with $210,000. Excuse me. So yeah, that's awesome. That way we'll only have to do couple of 2 or 3 missions and then we can buy the whole lot. Oh wait, of course we can sell the harvester. That might just be enough. And then we'll probably don't have any money left, but for a good cause. I will do that. I'll take a very quick break from there. Oh, we're definitely going to afford this. Okay, when we cut the harvester, I'm going to have to do that, okay? Seems like it's going to be... Then I'll probably just go with the... here. Nice break, wow. Alright, go go go. Fill up again. So, buy a harvester, buy a bigger dipper, and then buy a better cultivator. And we'll see from there. What I like about this game is you really have to do a lot before you can get better quickly. That also means that we all have to plant some more canola, because I'll be completely out of it. I actually should just, let's look at the price. If we speed up time, it will probably maybe get higher in the next hour. And if not, I'll just have to deal with it. So it's now 18:32. Oh, nice. So yeah, it's already down. So, what about sugar beets? Do I have sugar beets? Yes. Can I actually get it in here? I think I can. Is it also at the port? Yes. I'm gonna make some decent money. Excuse me for that burp right now. Sometimes it has to get out. LiveStream is offline. Oh, it isn't. Is it? That is it offline though, is it? It's not offline. I don't know why my stream checker says that it's offline because it really isn't. Oh no, it's crashing. That's not good. Let's overtake you. Oh wait. Ah, it's live again. Okay. So how much? Okay, so I'm going to do one load of canola and then some sugar beets. That will end up with 1500 canola left. And it's not too bad. And we have to sell the other harvester anyway, so. I'll actually sell the canola first and well, then we have 217,000 or something like that, and then we, if we sell our harvester, we'll probably have enough money to buy the other harvester. Like this for now. I know a lot of people like it when they have the cat here. I guess it's so that my screen is offline again. We don't have to sell the sugar beets. I think I will not do that because I believe I only get 1.6 times the value of it. Oh, it's for the 1.7 for the sugar beets. Okay, well that's okay. You've got me. Waste of time, so full speed ahead. out of the way, and you too, in your Audi? What Audi? No, it looks more like a Cadillac or something. Or a Toyota. Toyota something. Shut up and give me my money. So 117. Yes, okay. So let's see right now. Harvesters. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Am I going to bother with let's do something else for now. So I'm going to take the sugar beets to get some spare money and maybe, maybe we can buy a bigger tipper. That would be quite handy. To kill two birds with one stone. Yeah, let's do this mission first, then bring our tractor back to our farm and get the sugar beets, sell those, and get our harvester at our farm. And then get some dinner. Yeah, I said I would do that when I have my harvester. But I'm in a winning mood now. Up time a bit, maybe the prices for sugar beets will go up again. That's 1900 hours. So this should give me another $8,000. And then sell sugar beets for another, $8,000 maybe. A little less, I guess. That's 7,000. Maybe the prices will go up. Oh, nice. Yeah, maybe. so far. But sugar beets, hopefully the price will go up to just above 800, maybe 820 if we're lucky. Should I do one load of sugar beets? I don't know. Ticker was 20,000, right? Yeah. Maybe I can sell this ticker because I'm not going to do the thing anymore. So will the price go up? No, it will not. Okay. Too bad. That's only a difference of $7 per ton. So I've got 1500 canola. 1.5 tons, so I get 2,000 for that. That's 2,000. Not now. I'll just go with sugar beets for now. I do have to be very careful to load in the right ones and not the potatoes. Let's see. Are those sugar beets? No, I think the other ones are. Ah, nice. Yes, it are sugar beets. Positioning of net is pretty hard to do. Yeah, the sun setting. Shiny day in the island steps. Look at that harvester there. I'm going to pick you up soon. How much will I actually get for the dipper? 2,500. And the other one was 21,000. Okay. Yeah. I'm worth gonna think about that for a second. Please do not try that in real life. Thank you. same goes for this. Alright, so we've got nearly six, yeah, it's around 6 grand. Ooh, that's quite handy. Okay. So we need you. Yeah, no, we're definitely gonna buy the dipper. What a stroke of luck all of a sudden. Beacon, yes. Yes, we can. Forgot a bit there. Sorry. I'll do that next time. So yes, we got the Grand Hill Harvester and we're going to afford a bigger tipper. So we're making nice progress here. Can't wait to try the new harvester out because I've never had it. Funny that you make profit with a Profi Hopper from the first time you use it in the mission. And you get like 4,000 or more this mission. The Profi Hopper is only 3,500. But then again, it's really slow. Mostly slow. For the rest, it's a pretty decent thing. Position here so I can go there next time. It's only 2,500, but it's better than nothing. All right, so we sell this one. We buy this one. Oh yeah, look at that. Nice big tipper. All right, let's bring this baby home. Oh wow. Oh, sorry, tipper. Can I actually? No. Maybe I could attach the tipper at the back. Okay, it's really not that quick, but it has more horsepower than the other one, so it accelerates quicker. Let's turn up the time. Speed. No, I want to bring this home right now. Go straight to our field. I hope it's high enough for the new tipper actually. I've made that mistake before. Yeah, it's still slow, but it's better. At least it can handle more field at one time. Is that actually done? I'm not. Let's see. Oh no, it's not. Right, we'll get our worker doing that. Slow down time just a bit. So I can get my tipper. Really is some stupid ridge at the... or whatever. The side of it. Maybe damn high. So what I'm going to do, guys, is get the tipper, bring it home, and then I'm going to have some dinner, and I'll get back to you. I'll leave the stream running, but with a message that I'm having dinner. Almost wanted to drive straight to my farm, and I remembered that I should pick up the tipper. And this is pretty high, isn't it? I hope the pipe of the harvester is high enough. I should probably get a front weight for this one as well. Well, we can pick it up. no. Let's see if it's quicker when I don't wait to touch. That helps a bit. I can actually lower it. That might also help. Okay, but the main thing is... Oh yeah, that's high enough. Let's see. Oh, that will work perfectly. Alright, I'll leave this for now, guys. Save it, and I'll leave this running, and I'll get my notepad. Let's make this a bit bigger, shall we? So. Yeah, that should do it, right? I'll see you guys very soon. So here we are again. I don't want to save that. Playing for more than 5 hours today. Wow. All right, where were we? Why don't I have any sun? Oh, there we go. Oh yeah, I remember now. We're waiting for the crops to grow. And work. Oh yeah. Oh, this is a lot better. Now we're getting somewhere. No, overgrown campsite. Okay. Yeah. Let's do this. Okay. So we've got our bigger tipper, we got a nice harvester. Now let's get a bigger seeder. Like to have the some attachments for the tractor at the golf course, but I want to buy a really good tractor. I don't know which one, because the normal one I'm using, I don't know on top of my head which one it is the red one we already got. It has pretty much trouble when you attach both of good things, but taking corners and stuff. So I don't know which one I will get for that. I really want another tractor here as well. But I'll see what I can do. When we make some more money. Now the main priority right now is I'd like to have a seeder that also cultivates. Because, yeah, you can do two things at a time. So I'm going to check out how much it costs. And we'll see from there. First we need to make a bit of money. Alright, so he's full. Yeah, you can almost do half the field without you having to load it. So yeah, the sewing machines. Oh wow. So this one is for potatoes. I need to have a drill. Oh, this one. Yeah, I think I want this one. This one isn't that great. This one is a girl, right? It's 8 meters and this is 50 meters. 50 meters is a lot. This doesn't work very well with the fertilizer. Amazing sugar beets. I don't know if this actually got what it says is a drill, but I don't know. I don't want to take risks. This one would be ideal. But you should say this one is also a drill. I'll probably save for this one, and if it isn't great, then yeah, too bad then. We're gonna do this mission anyway. It's a fairly long drive. Yeah. Golf course. I really should fill this up. I'll do that next time. We have to go to the biogas plant anyway when we have collected our permit. And this is from, yes, from the golf course, so we should just go straight here. Yeah, the new harvester really, really is pretty good. I think it's the... I'm glad we purchased that as the second thing after this front over. So now we're going to save up for... Well... Like we have another field, like field 15, and then a bigger cedar. And then we have quite the tools to work with. I mean, with the bigger cedar and cultivator at the same time, we could handle pretty big fields, because it does take a lot less time to do it. Yeah, and the fertilizer is already pretty good because it has a span of 8 meters. So we're in pretty good shape. I should get some diesel for my front loader, as we are almost at 1/3 of a still capacity. Look at that precise dragging front. My driving is pretty decent in this game, if I may pat myself on the back. And if I may not, I just did. So. So apparently the harvester is still harvesting. Great. Now we have to drive to the biogas plant again. I wonder how much it will cost if you want to buy all the fields at once. Probably a couple of million? Millions? I don't know, I'm in the state of the game with my other single player game where I only have fueled 14, 15 and 16. So I don't know. How much everything costs. It's probably how I'm going to extend my farm. Well, first I'm going to buy field 15. And extend it with 16, then I want to buy 14 and 17, 18, 19, and then maybe to 13, and I think we've got lots of stuff to do when we've got those. Yeah, and I would like to have this field 7, and just make a lot of silage for the biogas plant, because you can make pretty much a fortune out of that. And I want to be careful here. Open. I want to get some sheep and some cows and get all that stuff working, and then I'll probably offer a field near the cows where I can hold the manure or whatever for the stuff for the greenhouses, which I will. I want to have a field with greenhouses. Yeah. nicely. And later we should check into the baling technology for the cows. And we really have to do one thing at a time. That's a lot of heat. Right, we'll keep you around here. Yeah, this machine only can do 20 kilometers an hour, which is 13 miles an hour. Still thinking whether I should get the better cheetah first or get field 15. I think I'll go with field 15. Because that way, no, they can just run some more money. And with the new harvester we can harvest quicker. And it's a bit of pain to plow the way through field 15. Try to do it as nice as possible. Ooh. Yeah, I should do this. I'll go for a bit and so like it and think that I can get this way. So, there we have it. I'll just go with it's two separate fields for now until we have got some we harvested both. And then we'll make it one big field. Because we have to cultivate it and cultivate it anyway. So that way we we don't have to worry about cultivating now, getting the field ready and cultivating again. And I don't like seeing my money in the red, but after this mission is all going to be good again. Well, they're apparently asleep. Some people are still awake in the village. And I'll do both fields with canola right now, and after that we will just alternate between different types. Why the hell am I driving here? It doesn't matter actually. whatever. I don't know which way I will choose to go to the biogas plant where we have to drop this load off. Yeah, I'll just go. That feels the most natural to me. Plus 30, 29, no, not 29, 19. Cut the village again. And then we're almost there. I mean, we've got 4 minutes, what could go wrong? So what will it be, field 19 or field 20? I'll go with 19, yeah. Nice to have finally got 2 fields. So we're approaching the village. I've got only 2 minutes left. Am I going to make it? I'm starting to second guess myself, but should be fine. And if not, then yeah, tough luck. Oh, it's still a minute and a half. Done this one before, haven't I? No. Oh, we've got a minute left here. Shouldn't be a problem, even though we're almost over $500 in there. Come on, yeah, I'll easily get it, but I think I could have had more time on the clock if I had chosen another route. Still 30 seconds left, so probably 200 or something left. Okay. I don't have to kill the board again, so don't go away. Just have to get the fertilizer. Fertilizer away. No. Okay. I see it for that too, of course. I think I'll actually, I'll fertilize the other food as well. That's on here anyway. Almost perfect. I just missed a couple of spots, but I'm not gonna bother. And usually I say that and do it as well, and I'm really not going to bother this time. Trust me. Okay, let's do it. Get a few real quick, and then we'll go to the golf course again. I wish there was a button that said go straight, and then you don't have to maneuver or steer all the time. All part of the game. I mean, you really have to steer as well, so. No car goes perfectly straight. Alright, so another jump roll then. Let's push it right back in. Keep going. Of course, it's going to be on the side. And field is definitely the easiest to move. That's the one at the campsite and the other one at the golf course. Okay. Yeah, then you can hit some bumps. This one is very easy. Flat. I think it'd be more of a challenge if you had to mow the green of the golf course. Alright, let me be done. Great. So, still only a cut. Yeah, I've got 1500 to mow there. Which after both of these fields will be 20,000. Alright, so we are done. Let's move to the next field. And you can do the same. Hello, hello. Alright. Gives me an opportunity to check out my phone real quick. Really, I haven't been doing anything except for playing this game today. Yes, I'll do that. That gun is bad, but I'm going to use it a lot from now on. I'm usually quite known for my bad guns in Dutch, but not so much in English, because I don't speak that much English except for my video. So I'll try to work on that. If people like it. And even if they don't like it, I'll do it anyway because I'm just lying. The guy with the bad thumbs. 20 did we need for that one? Okay. It says drill, but it doesn't explicitly say that it can. I mean, this one I'm sure it can, so I, so I'm either gonna say for this one, this one's also 3 meters, and this one, oh, 2.1, okay, yeah, so it's a big border. Yeah. I'm definitely gonna say for this one, and hopefully it will cultivate as well. I really do need a bigger one. This doesn't cut it. No. What's a great possibility that I would not be able to finish that mission. It looks like he was missing a fair bit. Yeah. Or was it just me? I do think I will not go on for that long tonight, because we're basically doing this for like 6 hours now, 7, something like that. So I'll probably just sow this field and call it quits. But I have something else to report tonight. And then I'll probably upload this to YouTube. Or at least edit it, the part where I was eating is not really that exciting to watch. I mean, it's like an hour of nothing happening. So yeah, I'm gonna finish this field, call it quits, just editing, record some other video, and alright, I mean, we can watch the cedar do its work, but I'd rather just do something else, like a mission. After that, the cedar is probably done, so that will be an excellent time to call it quits. So we have to go to the spinnery, and then all the way to the island, so it should take us 7 minutes, or I'll just check it. It's now 22 on my clock. He was cutting that corner pretty bad. Okay, so I have to go from there all the way to there. Looks like I should take the same route I'm taking now, so let's do that. I still have to fuel up. Yeah, it happens. So I'll go behind the turret, pick it up and bring it back. We've done this in just over 2 minutes, which means we'll probably have more than 1 minute left on the clock when we bring it back. With my pro front loader skills, let's get you out of the way. Oh, what am I? What? And then we'll check on our cedar real quick. Well, I think it will be done right and done right then. I assume. Did I just say port? No, I didn't write. Probably did. The island, I mean. If he isn't done sowing the field, then yeah. I already know that I need a bigger cedar. I mean, it takes about 10 minutes to see that thing, maybe longer. Oh well, I also had the small harvester and I harvested field 14 with it, and I think it literally took me about an hour. Because you have to be constantly there, and then your tipper is full, you have to unload it. All going at a blistering speed of 6 miles per hour. Well, the harvester at least, so. That's really, yeah, time consuming, so I'm glad we already got a bigger harvester, which does a lot more at the same pace, but I mean that those fields were harvested in no time. That's amazing. I think this span was twice as big. So yeah, that's just amazing. And we're going to deliver this with more than 1 minute on the clock, as I expected. This is a pretty long drive. But I can vaguely see the bridge already. Oh yeah, we'll do that with 1 minute and 15 seconds on the clock. Something like that. Maybe a bit more. Oh well, you can take care of these couple of things. So yeah, he's almost done. And after that I'm done. I really missed that spot with my fertilizer. Yeah. Yep, that's all part of the game. So yeah, when he's doing his last roll, I'm hereby saying thanks a lot for watching, even though there were only a few of you, but hey, I didn't announce my live stream or something, so I'm quite happy about it, and I hope I can get some more people watching the next time. Thanks a lot for watching, and if you want to see me on my YouTube channel, go to A Nook Plays Games. Oh, that came out really weird. That's A Nook Plays Games. And yeah, that's it basically. I had a great time. I hope you had a great time as well.